All right, let's talk about the point of a barrier. All right, so say we have a circuit. I'm going to have some qubit right here. I'm going to do a Hadamard to it. I'm going to do another Hadamard to it. And then I wanted to do, say, a measurement, whatever. Okay, so I take this circuit. It turns out this circuit does not really exist on our quantum hardware, on our superconducting hardware. It doesn't know what a Hadamard is. We need to do something called transpilot. So the interesting thing about transpilation is, A, it's a very interesting thing. It's kind of a way of compiling an abstract circuit into another kind of circuit, one that will run on your quantum hardware. So there's kinds of two ways you could transpile this thing. You could say, well, I know that if I do a Hadamard and I do an undo a Hadamard, then I can go ahead and think of this as an identity because this takes a 0 to a plus and a plus to 0. So I could actually just write that as a nothing and then a measurement. So I would get out whatever my input is. Or conversely, I could just say, well, I can treat this as a Hadamard, which would end up being something like an S, an SX, S dagger, an S, yeah, what is it? Something like this, S dagger. So these S's and SX's are the things that the quantum hardware actually knows how to operate, and they correspond to microwave pulses that would exist. So in this case, we're doing nothing because the transpiler knows, and maybe I should write that right there, transpiler. Because the transpiler is smart enough to know that two Hadamards in a row equals the identity. And so you just get the same result. In this case, it transpiles it into a series of microwave pulses that you actually execute. Now there's a big difference because this one's going to involve actual interactions with the hardware, and there's always going to be errors introduced, whereas this one involves no interactions. You're just going to measure whatever your input state is. So the thing about that is, if you want that second outcome, you put this barrier right here between. And that will tell the transpiler to always go in that direction. So now you know what you're doing. So there's a couple of reasons why you would want to do these kinds of things. For example, if you want to measure the coherence times, a lot of times you want to insert a different number of identities in a circuit after you prepare the qubit in a one state. And you want to see how many identities does it take before you always measure this in the ground state. So that is something called a T1 experiment. This will measure the relaxation time of the qubits. And if you were to stick this into the transpiler, it might combine all these identities together so that you would always just measure the one state. You would never get to the zero state. Your experiment would never end. But instead, what we do when we do this experiment is we would add a bunch of barriers between each one of these so that the transpiler still respects the fact that you're doing an identity transform that takes the same amount of time as a single qubit gate. And that's what a barrier is.